boys and girls, keep your pants on for your debriefing. This is Declassified, and today we're going to look at the Duca di Pasta. If you're here to get the down and dirty, no holds barred hot take, I'd say it's a solid meh. Meh and a half. But for something a bit more in depth, stick around because we'll talk some details. So while these gameplay clips play in the background, let me break down some stuff. First, let's talk commanders. A lot of the reviews I've seen so far are using Membelli to punch up the stealth and the agility of this cruiser. And this may break some brains here, but in these clips, I am using this setup for most of them. Sanzanetti, which may sound insane, but there is a method to this madness. And that is with the biggest weakness of this ship, and it is a big weakness. You see, it doesn't actually do any damage. Well, that's not entirely true. But let me get into it a little bit more detail. It's armed with 152s, and because the Italians lack equilibrium of power, your HE is going to be shattering mostly on battleships, and you have a pretty low chance of fire. I think it starts around 7% base. So your HE damage is mostly going to be anemic against battleships and pretty average against cruisers, though it does hurt destroyers. Now the AP, that is your moneymaker. If you can get into a position to use it, you can definitely put up some numbers, and so that's why I'm using Sanzanetti. Increased accuracy, increased penetration values, etc., etc. Basically, I am trying to make these guns as accurate and as punchy as I can, because who cares if you can survive a whole match if you can't actually hurt the majority of the ships? What with most battles being 5 battleships these days. So, that is the commander setup I'm using here. Well, actually not in this one. This is my speed run, but it is the commander I mostly use in the Abruzzi as well. And I'm having good to very good success with it. So there's that. Now, if you like more goofy stuff, you can put on Gleaves as an inspiration and change some perks around, and you can get your torpedoes to go over 13.5 kilometers, which I'm pretty sure might mean that they will get to where they're going just before the 15-minute game timer ends. I also tried out some fun stuff with Membelli and Von Muller and Fraser to get my speed up to 43.6 knots, so I think it might be possible to hit 44 knots. So there's that if speed turns you on. So what does this ship do that none of the others at tier 5 can't? Nothing I can think of. In fact, other than it being Italian and fast, which says a lot to me as a former Alfa Romeo owner, I'm not sure if I found anything this ship can do that would bring all the boys to the yard. The shipyard, that is. I mean, it is fine. It is funnish. At least it plays parallel to fun. I think if the Italians got equilibrium of power, that would change my views on this quite a bit, and would probably change my build entirely, or maybe come carriers, this will have a new role. Who knows? We can only go by what exists in the current state of the game, and in the current state of the game, the Duca is middle of the road. I have not gotten myself a Kraken in it yet, and I have put in about 150,000 XP. I used it to finish all the weeklies for the campaign, and as soon as I unlocked the Ochakov again, I took it out and was like, yes, this is what I'm talking about. Fast, agile, dangerous. And then I jumped back in the Duca, and while it is quite capable of wrecking, I mean, I can think of at least 3 Krakens I should have had if I hadn't been dumb. But while it is quite capable of wrecking, that wrecking is dependent on the red team having numerous destroyers or cruisers. Because battleships, you just don't have much you can do to them short of getting into a position to have their broadside and pumping out AP. Which again, does work. And here is an example of me doing just that. But more often than not, to get sustained fire into the broadside of a battleship will require you to be using islands, not necessarily its speed or agility. So yeah, another reason I'm not using Membelli. Now, one of the benefits Duca does get that the Abruzzi doesn't is that you don't have to run into tier 7 ships. So at worst, you're up against tier 6 cruisers you can definitely not be at a disadvantage against, or the destroyers since you have sonar. And more battleships you'll struggle to damage, and at best, You are top tier against cruisers you can capably handle and battleships you will still struggle to do much damage against, and destroyers you are very easily capable of dealing with. So where does that leave the Duca di Pasta? Middle of the road for me. I like it all right. The games are enjoyable, but not a ship that will be making its way to the top of my most played list. I don't think it will even be my go-to tier 5 cruiser for weekly premiums. That would be the Molotov, but it won't be my most avoided either, which is the London. It sits comfortably between the two. Should Arena Mode come back and it's tier 5 again? That might be interesting in an all-cruiser or cruiser-destroyer division, but for standard battles, I think there are better ships out there you could buy. I also think there are worse. I really have to wonder how it would be with Equilibrium of Power. Maybe someday we'll find out, but until then, it will be more of an okay-looking novelty, something you bring out when you have company over, but once they're gone, you put back on the shelf to collect dust, a description my ex in college used to describe me. So that's going to wrap it up for this review, folks. Questions or comments, you can leave them down below. Sorry it took so long, some last-minute real-world things came up. Like it or dislike, it's all good, and subscribe if you want to see more. I'll get back out there for another one soon, and we will talk then.